Well, good evening and welcome. Today is a day to give thanks. Give thanks for all that is good in the world. And good that we have today the love of our two young people here, of Bryan and Lauren. Today we celebrate a day of love, a day of happiness. In Ecclesiastes, we hear that there's a time for everything under the sun. So tonight, there'll be a time for partying, a time for dancing, a time for rejoicing. And right now we have a time for prayer. So let us just take a moment and just calm ourselves and feel God's presence.
For those of you who don't know me, I'm Aaron, Bryan's younger brother. And even though he and I are so close in age, we are definitely very different people. It's just a coincidence we went to the same college for the same major and entered the same job field, but I'm gonna say he copied me. And it wasn't the other way around. All kidding aside, I feel so lucky to be as close to Bryan as I am. Although our hobbies differ, we both share an appreciation of spicy food, competitive board game playing, T-Rex jokes, and an unabashed willingness to break out into any 90s boy band song or dance. So, Allie, shout out to you as well. Growing up, Bryan and I were best friends, and even though he's 2 years older than I am, we still got into a lot of trouble. Like when we attempted to videotape Santa Claus by hiding a video camera under a blanket and telling our father what we were doing. We were so shocked that the next morning Santa had found it. What brilliant children we were. Although Bryan started off his time at Geneseo to be a pre-med major, I'm very proud that he's taken up teaching. He is hardworking, dedicated to his students, and is striving to make a difference no matter what resources he may lack to do so. Wait, Bry, what does this next part say? I can't seem to read your handwriting. In all seriousness, I may be biased, but I could not be happier than when Bryan asks for my help in writing lesson plans or coming up with teaching materials or sharing ideas with him. Bryan and my age difference also meant that I was able to spend 2 years at Geneseo with him, which is how I got the chance to know Lauren. I first met Lauren when I went to visit Bryan at Geneseo his freshman year. And I don't know if they recognized it or not at the time, but I knew that Lauren was special. She sat with me outside a dorm room singing classic Disney songs, and this seems to be an ongoing theme, singing and dancing in our family. When I transferred to Geneseo, Lauren was another guardian during pledging, and as I got to know her better, I realized even more how incredible she is. She, like Bryan, has committed to a career of selfless service, and though she will try to downplay that point, she really is doing an amazing job with kids who really need the assistance. What really connects Lauren and I, though, is our mutual obsession with Harry Potter. And I'll never forget waiting in line with her for an hour and a half at Harry Potter World while talking endlessly about the series. Lauren has shown time and time again that she fits right into our family. She's an intense board game player, a foodie, and she even laughs at my dad's terrible jokes, like all of the jokes last night. Although, I hate to say it, Lauren, before you spend the rest of your life with Bryan, I think you need to know some things from the person who definitely knows Bryan best. Although you probably have some expectations of what marriage will be, I thought I'd enlighten you with the facts. So, you might expect Bryan to tell a nice, honest story of how he proposed to you, but in reality, the story will be that he almost threw the ring off the boat because he tripped and it landed in the water, and then he dove after it to save the ring and then proposed to you. Just keep that in mind. You also might expect him to share a really nice dance at weddings or parties, although I don't know how he was able to put that together up here. But in reality, you'll have to stop him from dancing when Watch Me Whip comes on, or any 90s boy band song. You might expect him to take nice family pictures at the holidays, but we all know that you will be picking out Bryan's clothing because he seems to get dressed in the dark. You might expect Bryan to remember important dates, like birthdays and anniversary years, but in reality, he'll surely remember every Heisman Trophy winner from the past 30 years. It's true. Yeah. But thank you for being born on a very memorable and easy day for him to remember. You might expect to go on nice date nights to the movies, but I think you already know that going on a date to the movie means seeing the Lego Batman movie or the newest sci-fi original movie or three-headed shark attack. And finally, you might expect to enjoy a happy, healthy, and long marriage, but in reality, I know that you'll be the most cared for, loving woman on Long Island, with a husband who will be spontaneous, adventurous, supportive, and adorable. Lauren, I'm so happy to welcome you into our family, even though it feels like you've been a member of our family for years. And congratulations, Bryan, you found someone who is very special and you will be spending an amazing rest of your life with. Everyone raise a glass to love, to laughter, to happy ever after. Congratulations, Bryan and Lauren.
Who would have thought over an icebreaker you two would be here now? Right? An index card, meeting at Geneseo. You know, you told me you were a card collector. And I think you've collected the greatest prize right now. Right. I want to give you the only words of wisdom I know. I've been married for 31 years. Listen to her. They're smarter than we are. Today you make your love real for us. You show us that God is visible in our world through your love. And we're here together to celebrate with you.
I, Bryan, take you, Lauren, for my lawful wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part.
I, Lauren, take you, Bryan, for my lawful husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part.
Mazel tov! I'd like to present you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Bryan. Right up.
Here. Good evening, everyone. For those who don't know me, I'm Lauren's older sister, Allie, and I stress older because people tend to be confused, and I'm going to ride that train for as long as people are confused that I am the older sister. Lauren and I are a unique pair of sisters. While we watched our friends engage in cage matches with their siblings, she and I sang and choreographed dances together. We were entrepreneurs. We charged cold, hard cash for our parents and their poor, unsuspecting friends, perhaps even a few of you here today, for the privilege to see us wiggle around to Ace of Base. In fact, I can only think of one fight we've ever had in our 20-something years of sisterhood, and it went something like this. We didn't talk for a half hour, and I said, "You know, I thought that was a really stupid thing." And you said, "Yeah, I know." And that was that, and we were over it. But don't get me wrong. If something's on Lauren's mind, she'll be sure to let you know. Did you sit next to her with your elbow out just a little too far? Did you set the table with the forks on the wrong side? Perhaps she thinks your outfit doesn't quite match. You better believe she'll tell you. Bryan, you sweet, easygoing man, I am so sorry. But I'm also not sorry. Because today you've married the smartest, kindest, most independent and fun-loving girl I know. I'm thrilled to call you my brother. You and Lauren complement each other so well. Beauty inside and out, brains, and two hearts of gold. From the moment I tasted your homemade fajitas for the first time many moons ago, I knew you had Lauren hook, line, and sinker, and we would be eating well from then on. Many of you know that Lauren and I lost our mother 3 years ago. I'm so glad that Mom got to meet Bryan and taste those fajitas, and that Bryan was there to help Lauren and all of us during that time. I honestly believe that Mom is here today, making sure the tablecloths are properly pressed, the chefs are cooking everything to her liking, and that everyone is having the best time. I'm sure she's also checking out those dark and stormies and danced right along with you to your wedding song. 16 years ago, I had a candle dedication ceremony during my sweet 16 party where I gave speeches to all of my loved ones. Lauren, what I said to you back then still stands today, because I'm a narcissist and I still have it. I'm glad to have you as my sister, and I wouldn't give you up for the world. Thanks for being the crazy, argumentative, funny, and loud you. And Bryan, thanks for being my funny, laid-back, and easygoing Iron Chef brother, Emma's incredible and daring uncle, especially when you toss her up in the air after dinner time, and an amazing new member of our family. We're so excited to have you. With that said, I'd like everyone to please raise a glass. Lauren and Bryan, I wish you a life together filled with love, happiness, and lots of wonderful memories. To the bride and groom.